Veggie Island, delicious plant-based dining in Taiwan. There's a famous vegetarian restaurant in Taichung's 7th redevelopment zone that has been so highly praised by vegetarians as a must-visit destination that I have to check it out for myself to see if it's true. Shall we? Enrich Restaurant and Café stands out for its innovative and creative approach to vegetarian cuisine. Skillfully crafting dishes that are not only visually appealing, but also bursting with flavor. The restaurant prides itself on using high-quality, locally sourced ingredients to create delectable and nutritious vegetarian delicacies. The story behind the restaurant is equally remarkable. It was founded by a team of passionate individuals who strongly believe in the power of plant-based eating for promoting both personal and environmental well-being. Their dedication to sustainability and ethical practices is reflected in their menu, which showcases a diverse range of dishes inspired by various culinary traditions from around the world. Whether it's their mouth-watering plant-based renditions of traditional Taiwanese favorites, or their fusion-inspired creations that bring together global flavors, they offer a dining experience that excites and satisfies even the most discerning palates. Weber, the founder of Enrich, grew up in a vegetarian family. Weber aims to offer creative, colorful vegetarian foods and interesting flavor combinations that even non-vegetarians will enjoy, allowing vegetarian food to fit seamlessly into their lifestyles. Enrich Restaurant's most famous signature dish is this one, the Super Fig Salad. The scale of fig cultivation is considered relatively small, with only 35 hectares in Taiwan. They are mostly grown in shade net greenhouses, but rot easily after cultivation, making them a highly labor-intensive and costly fruit to produce. Fig is also known as the fruit of longevity due to its fantastic health benefits. However, fig is a sickness fruit. In sickness fruits, the edible part is the receptacle.
无花果沙拉它的组成会有生菜，会有无花果，会有腌制物，然后会有我们自制的坚果。
Featuring seasonal ingredients such as pickles and fruit, this salad is healthy, colorful, and visually appealing.
我们使用的酱汁是用凤梨油醋酱，然后就是新鲜的凤梨加入柠檬汁，加入苹果醋，然后基本的调味，然后用橄榄油去增加它的风味，然后它顾及了里面的口感，然后多样性风味是我们的招牌。
Yes, we are here at Enrich Restaurant and Cafe, and this is their signature dish, the Super Fig Salad. Here we have over 15 fruits and vegetables. It's their signature dish, the Super Fig Salad. And sitting right here, I can just smell all of the fruits and vegetables. It's so fresh. I can't wait to eat this. It smells so, so, so good. I love figs. They're my favorite, especially on a salad. And oh, the candied mixed nuts and the strawberries, just even talking about it is making me salivate. This plate is magnificent. It's like a garden on a plate. It's beautiful. Such a lovely bite. The figs is so sweet, so tender. A little bit of saltiness from the feta cheese. And then you have a very soury tartness from the roselle. And then you get like a bitterness from the arugula, and then you have the balsamic. It's just blowing my mind.
Next up are the kale and blue cheese flatbread and Sichuan peppercorn flatbread, the restaurant's signature dishes. Let's see how these magical dishes entice even non-vegetarians.
因为我特别的喜欢鱼干蓝它烤完之后会有像海苔的口感跟海苔的香气，然后再加上我自己很喜欢吃blue cheese，因为我特别的喜欢那一种很特殊的cheese的风味，所以呢，我将blue cheese跟鱼干蓝做一个结合。当初开发这道薄饼的时候，因为自己家里面还有种甜菜根。 然后我把甜菜根切片之后去烤过之后，用喷枪把它喷上色。我很喜欢甜菜根的颜色，然后那时候在试做的时候就将这三个风味做结合。然后出来的时候呢，上面给它一些焦糖洋葱的味道，增加它的香气。因为 blue cheese 跟甜菜根跟胡桃，它本身的味道是非常的合拍的，用胡桃去增加它的口感。This
is the kale and blue cheese flatbread, and it was awarded by United Daily for the 500 plate award. It's a very subtle taste, and it's very good. It's packed with flavor, it's rich, you kind of get the saltiness of the blue cheese, and it doesn't stink. It doesn't stink. It's the pickled beetroot. It's so slippery, it's very juicy on the inside, and then goes very well with the leafy green kale. It's so crispy, perfect. I am in love with this.
这道薄饼呢，是因为我个人我们在煮员工餐的时候很喜欢煮中式的元素。有一次呢，我们在煮麻婆豆腐的时候，我就开始在想说川味变到薄饼上面。我就想说，我来制作一个剁椒加入皮蛋，然后我就把它变成剁椒皮蛋酱，它就变成我们的剁椒皮蛋这个薄饼的基底酱。然后上面呢，我会放过炸过的皮蛋，烤到半干的番茄。 至烧过的玉米笋，然后去把它做一个中式跟西式的合并。然后出来之后，我会加入碧玉花、香菜，然后烧烤酱、花椒油，整体它吃起来就是一个好像是中式又不是那么中式，又带点西式，属于我们自己的风味薄饼。
This is the Sichuan peppercorn flatbread. We have fried bitter melon, yet we have cheese and sun-dried tomatoes. I'm kind of scared and also kind of excited to try. Okay, let's give it a go. Wow. Oh my gosh, this is so pleasantly of a surprise. Like it's a lingering spice, which is very lovely. It's not like spicy to the point where you can't handle. And then afterwards, you can taste the texture of the egg.
Where it kind of just feels like a gelatin jello almost.
There would be like a great signature dish of a Western, Eastern kind of vibe. I would say this dish. Does it pretty darn well.
Tofu-stuffed 根饭，我对于这道菜是非常的推荐跟喜爱的。因为甜菜根的风味跟十字花根非常的合拍。 这道菜蓝纹乳酪的基底酱里面，我加入我们自己的烟熏油跟炭油去增加它的厚度，所以它吃起来不单单是甜菜根的风味，然后也有蓝纹乳酪的风味。如果你仔细品尝的时候，你会发现里面有一个炭香味，它就是我们自己制作的烟熏酱跟炭油去融合的味道。 因为我真的是太喜欢蓝纹乳酪的味道了，然后另外我在上面加入那个蓝纹起司，去增加它的风味性，也加入了我们自己腌制过的甜菜根，它是用盐巴，然后跟一些柠檬汁跟果醋去腌的甜菜根。那上面放的坚果，它是威士忌糖浆低温风干之后的威士忌坚果，然后一方面增加它的香气，然后一方面也增加它的口感。
Not only is the Barbie pink color of the beetroot and blue cheese risotto very visually appealing, but the beetroot sweetness perfectly balances the saltiness of the blue cheese in the al dente risotto rice, leaving it moist and fragrant. And the risotto is well complemented by the whiskey walnut garnish, which enhances its flavor. A tip to enjoy the best flavor of the risotto is to consume it while it's hot.
青龙臭豆腐呢，是我们这一季的招牌的商品。然后这一道菜呢，吃起来有酸，然后有臭，然后有新鲜感，然后也有台湾味，非常的推荐。我们要把臭豆腐打成我们要的风味线，然后用几花袋把它灌到我们的青龙里面之后呢，我们再用春卷皮把它裹上去之后，然后再去炸。 然后我们会自己熬制，烧烤的番茄酱，然后跟四川的红油，然后跟花椒粉，我们自己调了一个风味的花椒粉去做混合，把它当成酱汁。And
last we have the stinky tofu spring rolls. This is amazing. I was like, are these fried fingers? I thought it would be spicy. It's not spicy. Phew. Okay, that bite, I can, the stinky tofu. But it's doable. It's not too crazy, not too pungent. It's actually sweet on the inside.